Okay, I want to talk about Luke Cage, season 2, episode 2. I haven't seen the rest of the season yet, but so far it's becoming the best thing on TV in a very long, long time. Probably since Luke Cage, season 1. All right, now, episode 2 of season 2 is kind of slow, it's rebuilding the story. And remember how it ended in episode 1 with the preacher, Luke Cage's father. The preacher's talking about the fact that Luke Cage is not Jesus Christ. He's not perfect. He's just a man. He's subject to temptation, extortion, subject to sin, that he might actually use his power for evil, right? And not, he might have great ideas about the city, and he wants to save the city, right? But he could justify all the wrong things he needs to do in order to bring about this utopian idea, right? Utopian city that he wants to have. And you have his antagonist, the villain of the story, Bushmaster, who's got the same goal as Luke Cage. He wants the city for himself. So we got this two big, really huge, big egos with superpowers that's going to fight one another or try to, and going to try to influence the people of the city to become masters of the city, basically. Right? And that's the danger of it. And we see Luke Cage's father in the episode 1 talking about the danger of following a man or putting your trust in a man, because no matter how of good intentions he may have, in order to get there, he's going to have to do some kind of evil, because we are subject to that. Right? It was beautifully done. Now, how do you top that? Well, in episode 2, we get to see that little hint of Luke Cage going in that path, a man, right? To bring about going the path that's not the right path, let's say. It's the wrong path. Because he has a workout in front of a camera to show off how strong and how fast he really is. And there's a character who represents Nike who wants to sponsor Luke Cage. Now, I don't think Luke Cage took that money yet, but I have a strange feeling that he might in the future. All right, so you get to build up a little bit. We get to see Bushmaster, and we get to see the fact that the bullets hurt him a bit, but he's going to overcome it, right? So he has superpowers. There are some stories that it's been built up a bit. It's kind of slow. However, at the end of episode 2, it brings all things together, and that's the beauty of this episode. You get to see a blues musician playing the blues. All right, wonderful song. The lyrics is awesome. And we get to see Luke Cage getting kind of frustrated about the things that's going on, because he is a superhero but cannot clean up a city yet, right? There's frustration because the police is not really helping him either. So he's getting frustrated. And at the same time, you got Luke Cage's father preaching again. And I hope and pray that he preaches in every episode, because it is awesome. Because the sermon he chooses to give comes from Romans chapter 12 at the end of it. Now, Romans chapter 12 is at the end of Romans, where Paul is telling or giving advice to Christians on how to live that life, what it means to live a Christian life. He's kind of going over that. There's a lot of positive things in here, but at the end of chapter 12, he gets a little negative. In a sense, he says, do not do something. What was that you're not supposed to do? Recompense to no man evil for evil, but be diligent to do good before the presence of all men. All men, not just good, but also men who are not so good or evil. Right? Do not repay evil for evil. All right? And then it says in verse 18, this is a verse that the preacher talked about. He says, verse 19, dearly beloved, avenge not yourselves. Avenge not yourselves, but rather restrain your wrath, for it is written, vengeance is mine. That's God talking about it. Now, the preacher in this show, I mean, does a beautiful job. And I've taken a class called Black Preaching when I was in seminary, because I'm not a great preacher. I don't know how to preach and perform in front of an audience very well. I love talking about the Bible and things like that. But to be able to preach in front of a bunch of people, that's something that I'm not pretty keen on, all right? But I took that class because when you watch TV and you get to see different preachers that's on TV from time to time, black preachers are the best. Well, it's not because, not just because the words of the Bible is being, let's say, explained better, but it's the motions behind it, right? It's the delivery of the sermon that is so powerful and so good that I wanted to see what it takes to preach like that, all right? hey, I got an A in that class. All right, but I've seen a lot of black preachers, but this preacher, man, he is a pro, and I'm thinking maybe he is a preacher himself or a wonderful, great actor. All right, he's preaching, and the church, the congregation, is maybe a quarter full, so he's not popular yet, but he needs to be. I'm sure he's going to be. And episode one, he says something wonderful. Luke Cage is not Jesus, just a man subject to sin. And today he talks about the fact that Bible says that we should not, avenge not yourselves, right? Avenge not yourselves, but rather restrain your wrath, for it is written, vengeance is mine. Let God do it. Now, the preacher in the show actually says this. He says, look, God has given man a lot of responsibilities because he trusts us, right? To be able to even have a family to raise children, that's a great responsibility. But God says, I believe in you. I trust in you. I give you the responsibility of raising children and do a good job. And most people, I think most people do a decent job, if not a really good job. But that's a great big responsibility. But when it comes to vengeance, he says, don't do it. Don't do it. Let God do it. Why? The preacher says here on the show, he said, because vengeance is toxic. All right. Now, I got a smile on my face when I said that. I don't know why I smile all the time. That's no good. Because vengeance is toxic. See, I can't do it right. Anyway, the preacher does a wonderful job. The way he looks, the delivery is perfect. His vengeance is toxic. Right? Paul talks about in Romans 12 earlier, there's two paths to right. One path that leads to righteousness, all right, which leads to eternal life. Another path that leads to sin and destruction, which leads to death. One or the other. Right? And vengeance is going to the path, right, of evil. Now, the preacher on the show didn't really go over this part, but I'm sure he would have if the whole 40-minute show was about him preaching, all right? So they had to cut it down a bit. But the thing is, the reason why we as human beings want to avenge for ourselves is because we have rules, we have laws, right? And when a law is given, there are lawbreakers. And if the law breakers are there, that person needs to be punished. But what you notice, however, is that not everything on earth is fair when you go by that by law. It's not fair. Some people get more time in jail than others, more fine than others. Other people just get away with a lot of things. All right, it could be for many different reasons. But when that happens, we get angry, right? Because we're supposed to follow rules, we should follow law, but if the punishment, right, is not given or it doesn't fit right, then we get angry. So we need to revenge. We need to revenge ourselves. We need to bring about justice. And that's what superhero shows are all about, isn't it? Marvel has the Avengers, they call themselves. They have to avenge the wrong that's been done. And then there's the DC, the Justice League, which is the same thing, right? We need to bring about justice in the world, and we're going to fight. But look how many episodes after the comic books that come out, because there's no such thing as justice, because maybe little justice here and there, because people keep breaking laws, right? And people keep doing wrong to us. We might do some wrong to others as well. All right. So, and we need, everybody needs punishment one way or the other. So, there's no healing involved here. Not at all. So it is toxic. Vengeance is toxic. And then the preacher goes by telling about this Cherokee tale about the two wolves, which is the same thing as what Paul said about two paths. One that leads to righteousness, one that leads to death. All right? Two wolves. Which one is stronger, you say? Now, a lot of Christians think, oh, it's easier to sin. That's not true at all. Now, if you only go by the law, yeah, sin is easy because all you got to do is break certain rules. And everybody's guilty of that, right? But the path of righteousness is just as easy or just as hard as other paths. It really depends on, as the preacher says about the Cherokee, about the two wolves, is which one is stronger? The one that you feed. So if you want vengeance, all right, then you're going to have to feed the wolf that leads to sin and death. That's why God says, avenge not for yourself, for vengeance is mine. Let God take care of it. As the preacher said, because we have to admit whether we like it or not, sometimes God knows best. We don't know. Only God knows. God will do it. Trust in Him. That's what the Bible seems to say. So that we don't have to worry about going into that toxic way of life, but stay on that path of righteousness. I think that's very important. Right? So on verse 20 says, therefore, if your enemy hunger, feed him. That's the upside down from what the world says. If he thirst, give him something to drink. For doing so, here's the reason why. You shall heap coals of fire on his head. Now, heaping coals of fire on his head doesn't mean literally. The coal was referenced in the Old Testament as a way of bringing in forgiveness. If a coal touches your tongue, it means it forgives you for all the wrong speech, kind of a thing. So the idea is that you could throw a heap of forgiveness onto his head so that he may turn from the path of the wolves that do evil in the world to the other path, the path of righteousness. One way or the other. Because we want everyone to walk into that path of righteousness. But if you have vengeance in your thought, if you become toxic in your way you think and do in life, because you want justice, you want to avenge, right, then you are definitely not going to make the world better. You're repaying evil for evil. So the preacher talks about his own son, Luke Cage. He's just a man. He could feed that, right? Wolf that leads to death. The wrong path. Path of sin. And it kind of looks like Luke Cage is walking in that way. Kind of sad because I really like Luke Cage too. But as an evil one, or not an evil person, he probably has good intentions. But the way he's going to do it is not good. He'll justify it, right? Just like how episode 1 seemed to talk about. But he's definitely going into the wrong path. Definitely. Right. So the preacher is right, and the scripture is right. We have a choice. Which wolves do you want to feed? Now, I know the world says vengeance is the best way. Justice, to bring about justice, we have to, you know, bring about punishment. Right. But we also have the power to forgive. Right? Not to go in that toxic path. And I think that's why somewhere in the Bible, I remember reading it, says, if you forgive someone, then that person will be forgiven in heaven as well. I mean, that's quite a big responsibility. So even though we might think we have the right to bring about vengeance, God says, don't do it. Let Him take care of it. Give it unto Him so we could keep our path, right, our feet in the path of righteousness. Righteousness. I think that's incredibly important. Okay? Anyways, I was going to mention something at the end. What was it? Oh, yeah. How are you going to apply this? How are you going to apply this in today's life? What's popular today? What are people really angry about? All right? When I turn the TV on or on the news, my wife watches The View, so I watch that. What people are really upset at Trump? Okay? Now, personally, I don't really know exactly why he may have said something about our intelligence that he shouldn't have said. He's mentioned something about the server. But whatever it is he said, there are a lot of things he says, or few things that he has done in the past that people are picking on. But everybody's calling out for blood, right? Impeach him now, throw him off, bother him wherever he goes. In fact, if you see anyone supporting Trump, cause trouble, you know? I mean, that's what people are calling for. Now, how is that going to bring about peace? Huh? That's because of that, everybody's going to be walking in the path of evil. You're feeding the wrong wolves here. All right? What we need to do, if you're really upset at Trump and all his followers, instead of calling the Trump followers deplorable or uneducated or whatever bunch of names that you're calling it now, maybe we should listen to what Obama and his wife Michelle said. When people go low, we go high. Maybe that's a better thing to do. And what does it mean to go high? It means, right, even if they're your enemy, feed them if they're hungry. Right? Give them something to drink when they thirst so that they could bring about healing in the relationship, that we could all walk in that path of righteousness. Maybe that's the best thing to go. So if you're upset at Trump, what the advice of the preacher and the Bible is to say, be kind to those you might consider your enemy. Right? Don't go farther away from Trump just to, you know, be the opposite end of him. All right, that's all we see. We got two extremes going at it now. And we're in the middle going, civil war? There's no way. But let's bring about healing. All right, we know how to do it. I know it's upside down. I know it's going to be difficult. But let's listen to the Word of God. The Word of God, I think, is so very more important today, because the way of this world right now is toxic. All right, I still have a smile on my face when I say that. I gotta learn not to do it. The way that things are going in this world, it is toxic. It's no good. All right, the show is awesome. Luke Cage, whoever wrote this episode, congratulations, you're awesome. I hope the rest of the season is just as good. All right, because so far I say this is the best show, best thing on TV since Luke Cage. Season 1. Very excited. God bless you. I'll see you next time.